Who is Holy Spirit?
Jesus.
Holy Spirit, yes.
We are the three persons.
One of the three persons. Three persons in one God in three persons. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. What is Holy Spirit's name? Holy Spirit's name?
God the Holy Spirit.
God the Just as my name is Tony Francis, just as his name is Mark Lakpati, in the same way, Holy Spirit's name is Holy Spirit. What is the name of Holy Spirit? Holy Spirit. Yeah, that is his name. Okay, so we have three God in one person in three God. How do we understand this? One God in three person in one God. How do we understand this?
Holy Trinity.
Yeah?
Holy Trinity.
Holy Trinity, very good. That's Holy Trinity. Three in one, one in three. Okay. But how do we understand that? Santa Claus?
As we make the sign of the cross.
Okay. But how do we understand? Three person in one God, one person in three God. How do we understand? God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. God. All three?
In God.
One God. But one God, three person. How do we understand? When we are thirsty, what do we drink?
Water.
Okay. And when someone wants to drink cold water, what do we put in that water?
Ice.
Very good. And then when mama is cooking something, what comes up?
Steam
comes up. So all three are what?
Water.
All three are water. No? Ice is also water. Water is also water. Steam is also water. But steam, we do not drink. With ice, we do not take bath. Yes or no? We do not do that. In the same way, all the three persons have different work. But all are one God. Just as there is ice, there is water, there is steam, all three are one. In the same way, we have one God in three person in one God. Agreed? Got the idea? Very good. Now, Heavenly Father, our Father, is a creator. Who is he? Who created the world? Who created the world? Jesus was there. Holy Spirit also was there. But who created the world? God created the world. And who saved us from sin?
Jesus.
Jesus is our Redeemer. Okay? And who sanctifies us, makes us holy?
Holy Spirit.
He is holy, so he is making us holy. So all this power which we have from God the Father, he created us. We committed sin, Jesus saved us, and today we are all in the ministry of God. It is because of Holy Spirit. All three different works. Okay? Praise the Lord. All three different works. But three persons in one God. Now, all three of them work together. If we go for a mass, we begin with in the name of the Father, no? When we start a prayer, we begin with in the name of the Father, okay? And when Father, Deacon or Bishop does the baptism, he uses the word, I baptize you in the name of the Father, Son and the Holy Spirit. When the blessing is done, same thing, Father, Son and the Holy Spirit. So all three are involved in our blessing. One is a creator, second is a redeemer, third is a sanctifier. But we do not know much about Holy Spirit. When I was small of your age, I did not know it. Today, y'all are very lucky. and I understand this parish is blessed. I'm not charaving. This parish is blessed because there is a children ministry and y'all are getting something which I got when I was, say, around 40, 45 years old. I got it at that time. What y'all are getting now? I was unaware of Holy Spirit. Who is Holy Spirit? I did not know. When it was asked in our class, who is the Holy Spirit, we used to think that it was Mother Mary. We did not know about it. Even at the time of confirmation, the mind was not ready to grasp the work of Holy Spirit. But today, you are getting more and more knowledge about Holy Spirit. He is the one who sanctifies us. He is with us in all of us. Today is present here. That's why you were able to do that song, no? You were able to do action and all. Why? Because the presence of Holy Spirit. It is only when He is present, we will be able to do God's work. If He is not present, we will not be able to do God's work. Now, we can recognize, we can see Him in the scripture. If you read a line, anyone has brought a Bible? Mark, come. Mark Lakpati, Mark chapter 8 verses 35. Kindly take it. Mark chapter 8 verses 35. Scripture. Now how do we understand this? I will be asking you all question and you all have to answer. Okay? Read.
For those who want to save their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake and for the sake of the gospel will save it.
What did she say? What was it our sister read? If you want to.
For those who want to save their lives.
Save their lives. One who want to save his life.
Will lose it.
Will lose it. And one who want to save his.
Lose their life. Lose their life for my sake.
For God's sake.
And for the sake of the gospel. Will save it.
How do you understand that? Any idea? Tell me.
That if we want to save ourselves, we cannot save and we will lose our life. And if we...
But that is what she read.
Yes.
You are repeating what she read. But what do we understand? Come. Doesn't matter, huh? Keep it up.
We understand that if we lose our lives for God's sake, then God will save us.
How we lose our life for God standing in front of train? God, I am giving my life for you. Yes. It's difficult, no, to understand. My cousin, I am asking you, is it difficult, no? You understand what we are trying to say? If you try to save our life, we will lose it. If you try to lose our life for God's sake, we will save it. I'll tell a small story. Two men, holy person, they were walking along the mountain. They were climbing the mountain. Winter time, snow was falling, it was very cold, and both of them were walking. Down below the valley, they saw one man. He was fallen down there. So one said to another, they were walking, "Let's go and help him." The other said, "No, it is very cold. I cannot go down there. I will die. Better I be here." Then he said, "Okay, if you do not want to go, I will go and help him." He came down. That fellow sat down over there and he came down. When he came down, he lifted that man. He saw that he was alive but unconscious. Lifted his arm, brought him up the mountain, came up, and then what he saw was this man who was waiting there, he died. He was alive. This person who went to help, he was alive. How can it be? How can it be? But how can we have to answer? No, okay. That is what we called a Ramban answer. राम ने जब धनुष मार दिया ना लगने वाला है रावण को, वो 10 सर आ गया ना रावण का, उसके वजह से दुकान में 10 पैकेट, वो पैकेट सिगरेट में 10 सिगरेट था। रावण जब सिगरेट लेता था तो 10 सिगरेट लगता था उसको, एक 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 एक, एक, एक। राम बन जावा। हाउ कैन यू आंसर दैट? दिस मैन हु वेंट अटल,
द पर्सन हु लेड हिज लाइफ फॉर दैट पर्सन, ही हैड लिसनड टू गॉड एंड द पर्सन हु हैड जस्ट वेटेड देन and he was not listening to the other person, he was listening to Satan, so he died.
Okay, good. When this man went down, he carried him, what happened? That he needed strength, his blood became hot. When his blood became hot, that the cold which was there had no effect on him, whereas this man who was sitting, he was just shivering and he died over there. This man who went to help someone, God gave him strength to carry him, his blood became hot. So when he took him up, when he brought, he saw by that time he became very strong because his blood became hot. Same thing with the other man whom he had carried, he also started to show some life. This is how. He did not think about his life. He said, I will go and save him. And he was saved. One who wanted to save his life, what happened to him?
He died.
He died. And one who never thought about death, what happened to him? He lived. So who helps us in understanding this phrase? Once again, will we read it? Now you will understand. This is the work of Holy Spirit who guides us.
For those who want to save their life will lose it. And those who lose their life for my sake and for the sake of the gospel.
This man went and said, this is the work of the Holy Spirit. It is the Holy Spirit who gives us, who created by God, who gives us life. We are created by God, but life, how to live, this is given to us by Holy Spirit. He helps us. Zacchaeus was a short man. He was a robber. In a way, he was a robber, cheating people, collecting money and all those things. One day, Jesus was passing by. Something happened in him. Something, no one knows what happened. What was the force behind it that made him climb up the tree and he saw Jesus. When he saw Jesus, Jesus was there standing below the tree. Today I will be with you in your house, Jesus said. And he came down, caught Jesus and said, whatever I had with me, I give back to the poor. Who made it possible? Who made it? He came to Jesus. Holy Spirit. It was the Spirit. How you all came today? Because of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit has brought you over here. It is the Holy Spirit who works in our life. He is responsible for us. Sometimes what happens, we do not accept him. Then he will stop coming. He will say, come on, go for prayer meeting. Come on, sit and say rosary. Listen to mama. No, I don't want. Then he will not say again. Because Holy Spirit speaks only once. And when we listen to him, he starts speaking again. That's Holy Spirit. Okay. Now, which are the 7 gifts of Holy Spirit? We have 7 gifts of Holy Spirit. No? Which are they? Isaiah chapter 11 verses 1 and 2. No, don't read. We'll ask our children. They are very clever. Actually, unmarried are children. That's the proof of the Holy Spirit. When we accept Holy Spirit, you also, I'm telling, when you accept Holy Spirit, when you get up in the morning, just say, good morning, Holy Spirit. Talk to him. Learn this habit of talking to Holy Spirit. When you start talking to Holy Spirit, he will keep on guiding you. He will help you. Even in your studies, Holy Spirit, I do not understand this. This passage, I did not understand. He gave me a story. This is the story. Give to your children, they will understand this. Simple story. Holy Spirit. So which are the 7 gifts of the Holy Spirit? Which are they? Wisdom, very good.
Knowledge.
Huh? Knowledge, very good. What is the difference between wisdom and knowledge? What is the difference between wisdom and knowledge? Knowledge is something we know. No, if I do not listen to my daddy, he will shout at me. Knowledge, I know. Wisdom is something which makes which a wise person has. Everybody do not have, only wise person. People who are wise, they have wisdom. Okay? Wisdom, knowledge. Third one.
Understanding.
Understanding. You only read, tell. Which are they? So we can tell to our children, no? 11.2, Isaiah. The seven gifts of Holy Spirit. Ask. Jesus says, ask and you will receive. This is what he's telling to us. He's not telling us to ask for vada pav, masala dosa. No, he's telling us to ask this. Ask what? The gift of Holy Spirit. The fruit of Holy Spirit. We'll come to that. Okay, then I will read it. Mila ke nahi mila? Wisdom, knowledge, understanding, courage, Isaiah, counsel, fear of the Lord, I read it. Which are the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit? Very important. Children, ask God for the gift of Holy Spirit. I say that you will prosper in your life. You will prosper in your life. Which are they?
The spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord.
Fear of the Lord. What is fear of the Lord? What do we understand by the word fear of the Lord? Fear of the Lord? Gift of the Holy Spirit, what is fear of the Lord?
Before doing any bad work, we have to think that what will be the price for this?
Punishment. Okay, one is your punishment. Anything else? Anybody else? Divija? To obey him. Okay, fear of the Lord. Anything else? In fact, Divija gave a right answer. When God says us something, we have to obey. That is fear of the Lord. It is not that he is going to punish us. God never punishes us. We punish ourselves. How we punish ourselves?
By sinning.
Daru peene se kya kharab hota hai?
लीवर
खराब होता है कौन दारू पिलाया गॉड पिलाया क्या मैं पीता हूँ हम पीते हैं क्या गॉड पिलाते हैं हम पीते हैं सो लीवर खराब किसके वजह से होता है मेरे वजह से होता है ना गॉड डजंट पनिश एनीवन जीसस हैज पेड द प्राइस फॉर इट ओनली थिंग वी हैव टू गो एंड कन्फेस आवर सिन टिल टुडे गॉड हैज नॉट पनिश्ड एनीवन Till today, I'm talking from the time of New Testament, from the time when Jesus gave his life on the cross, he has not punished anyone because Jesus has paid the price for our sin. But we have to not sin again. That is one thing. At the same time, Jesus is interceding for us, human being. That's why he gave us the sacrament of confession. Who have not received the first Holy Communion? All have received, no? Ha. So make it. Not okay, make it a practice of going for confession. God never punishes us. Then we